which tonight comes from Tony Whitehead, health educator and chairman of the Terence Higgins Trust.
AIDS, acquired immune deficiency syndrome, was first identified in the United States in 1981. Since then, 6,000 Americans have died. Across Central Africa, where it originated and where it is primarily a heterosexual disease, countless more have died. This pattern is being repeated throughout the world. In the United Kingdom, 200 people have been confirmed as having the disease, and over half are already dead. Thousands more are infected. In the coming year, we can expect at least double that total. It is the worst public health problem since the war. The only proper way for society to view this threat is as a challenge. Clearly, it challenges medical scientists. They have made great progress, but there is no cure in sight. But it also challenges our whole society, both public and political, and in that challenge we are failing. Where we should find informed concern, we find instead hysteria or callous indifference. And instead of the compassion that should be the natural response to suffering, we see recrimination and condemnation. I have known people with AIDS evicted from their homes, sacked from jobs and estranged from family and friends. Young people courageously face death, while the cause of their suffering is made the subject of jokes in the media. Hospitals have not received the funds so urgently requested. The explanations for this may be varied and complex, but two features are particularly important. The first is the way in which the media have reported the disease to a public who believed that serious infectious diseases were a thing of the past. The media have not only failed in communicating the complex issues involved, but have at times blatantly misrepresented them. Therefore, many members of the public are left in the mistaken belief that AIDS cannot touch them, while others are afraid that simply being near someone who might have it poses a problem. The second arises from the fact that AIDS is usually sexually transmitted, and at least in the developed nations has hit gay men hardest so far. This has exposed the depths of society's prejudices. We hear of people who have contracted the disease through blood being described as innocent victims, implying that others are culpable for their illness, especially gay men. AIDS is not a moral issue. It only requires looking beyond issues of sex and sexuality to our shared humanity to realize this. Of course, it is unrealistic to expect people to be able or even to want to shake off such deep-held prejudice. But it should not be unrealistic to expect those in positions of power to govern their actions by higher principles. Hospitals, the gay community, people with AIDS, and many friends are working together fully aware of their responsibilities to each other and to society. That responsibility, effort, and determination should be supported by clear-sighted government in providing extra funds and avoiding ill-conceived control measures such as forced detention. The media must recognize its role in educating the public. With disease, there are no guilty and no innocent, only young lives cruelly cut short.